I'm Nick Leister from the SolidWorks training team. SolidWorks provides a flexible environment for accessing features, but mouse gestures offer the quickest way to open and switch commands. In this video, I'll show you how to work faster by leveraging mouse gestures to access common commands quickly. I'll also show you how to personalize your mouse gesture prompt with the commands you use most often. Here, I have a partially defined sketch open. I'm in the early stages of modeling a plastic handle for a vacuum cleaner. I will clean up this sketch and reference some of the existing geometry before I use a spline to model the handle's profile. Using the shortcut and in-context menus allow you to work faster than if you were to access commands through the drop-down menu or the command manager. However, mouse gestures allow you to access commands even faster. Hold the right mouse button and move the cursor to access mouse gestures. I'll swipe the cursor over the Smart Dimension command to constrain the handle's end. By default, SolidWorks enables 4 gestures. However, the number of gestures and available commands are customizable. Let's customize the mouse gestures to add more commands. To customize mouse gestures, expand the Options dropdown and click Customize. This menu allows you to configure SolidWorks in several ways, but we'll focus on mouse gestures for now. This video focuses on the mouse gestures within the sketch environment, but you can also use mouse gestures in the part, assembly, and drawing environments. I'll customize my mouse gesture menus to have 8 commands. I'll also customize my mouse gestures so the spline command is in the upper right-hand corner in the sketch environment. To do this, I'll type spline in the search. Now, I'll drag the spline command to the upper right-hand corner of my sketch mouse gesture menu. Now when I access my mouse gestures, I see my 8 custom commands. I'll swipe over spline to enter the spline command. I'll reference the existing sketch entities to draw my spline, which will form the bottom portion of the handle. I'll follow the same procedure to draw the spline representing the top portion of the handle. Mouse gestures allow me to enter the command very quickly. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access a video-based lesson on modifying the SolidWorks user interface.